at Augusta Financial is the consummate mortgage professional, committed to helping you turn your dream of homeownership into reality. With more than 22 years in the finance mortgage industry, Marla brings extensive experience and top knowledge to help make your loan experience hassle-free. Given her honesty, integrity, and attention to detail, she is the loan officer you can trust. Marla knows what it takes to get you the best loan, the best rate, and the best service in the industry. You'll find Marla Ferris at Marla, F-E-R-R, is.com.
Take the stress out of moving. Affordable Quality Moving and Storage has been owned and operated in Santa Clarita since 1996. They excel at relieving you of the pressures of moving. You can be assured your belongings are safe and will arrive at your new location, whether it's down the street or across the country. Discover the difference. AQMS, Affordable Quality Moving and Storage. Read the reviews online at aqmsnationalmoving.com. AQMS, Santa Clarita's favorite moving company. Let's talk about insurance. Are your rates skyrocketing year after year, or do you feel like you would benefit from a professional advisor that works for you? Give the great team at Voy Insurance Solutions a call. Voy works with dozens of the best insurance companies to help you obtain competitive rates and comprehensive coverage. Homeowners, auto, business, and life insurance. Voy Insurance. Right price, right coverage, right now. Mention the Phil Nordella Show and get a free $10 Starbucks card. Visit voyinsurance.com. That's voyinsurance.com.
Are you confused with all the craziness that's going on with the real estate market these days? Well, if you are, you're not alone. I'm Phil Nordella, and I have the knowledge and experience to help guide you through all the confusion. I'll answer your questions and help advise you so that you can accomplish your real estate goals. You can call me directly at 661-312-3561 or get online at philnordella.com. And don't forget, you can always listen to my radio show called Real Estate It's That Simple here on KHTS every Friday morning at 10 a.m. Phil Nordella, eXp Realty, it's that simple.
The following is sponsored programming and does not necessarily reflect the views or opinions of KHTS or its ownership.
You're listening to Real Estate It's That Simple with Phil Nordella and Taylor Williams-Moniz. Brought to you by AQMS Moving and Storage, Marla Ferris of Augusta Financial Inc., Braveheart Pest and Termite Control, Castle Real Estate Inspection Services, Donahoe Young and Williams, Style My Space, and VOI Insurance Solutions.
And you're standing on the edge, face up, cause you're a natural. I've been in heart of stone. You got a piece of code to make it this world. Yeah, you're a natural.
Hey, okay, welcome to Real Estate and Other Stuff on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live. Hi, everybody.
Good morning.
I'm your friend of the real estate business, hopefully, and Taylor Williams-Moniz, my right, your left, is your favorite real estate attorney, among
Woo-hoo!
Other things.
Thank you.
She's a full partner over Donahoe Young & Williams, which is an incredible firm. We all know that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Did you happen to see, what did I, oh, you know what I called you on Facebook?
What?
When it came to doing the show?
Mm-mm.
Hard charging Taylor Williams-Moniz.
Oh, my gosh, I like it.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like that's an accurate description.
It fits.
Especially given the cases I've been dealing with the last 48 hours.
Hard charging.
Ooh, it's been a week.
Yep. Fun, huh?
Yeah. So how are you?
Crazy.
So, yeah, you've got all kinds of fun stuff to talk about.
Yeah, you know what? We've got a house, not full, but Judy's two sisters are in town.
So fun.
Yeah. And
very
if they're
nice.
Listening, I'm going to give a code word, because they
Ooh.
Said that they were going to listen or watch. The code word is Niagara Falls. And if I go home and say, what was the code word, and she doesn't know, that means they weren't listening.
Greg, if you're listening, text me the code word.
Oh,
he
yeah.
said he
oh,
was listening. He's in Manhattan right now.
And we should have always done that. If somebody says, hey, I'm going to listen to the show, I'll say, okay. Okay.
This week's code word
is,
I know we should have.
007. Yeah,
okay.
So anyway,
we'll
so Sarah and Helen, they're here. Nick and Lance came down.
Oh,
and
I
so
know.
They're
I can't
here.
Have all these people and you didn't invite me over. How rude. I'm just kidding.
No, let me see. Hang on a sec. What do I have to
I
say to that?
Nick
Not
and
a darn
Lance.
Thing.
I love Nick
Yeah,
and Lance.
You know what? And they were here for like 24 hours and then Lance had to have some things checked on his back because he had a broken back. So he actually went down to... they went and stayed in a hotel last two nights.
Okay.
So
nice.
I felt bad for Barkley because Barkley's like, oh my God, Pop-Pops are home, Pop-Pops
right?
are home,
yeah.
and then they're gone
then they
again.
Left. I know.
And then she's just walking around like really kind of, yeah.
We need to shout out to one of my really good friends,
oh,
Mark
yeah.
Umamoto, who oh. listens every week. He just oh. texts me Niagara Falls.
Oh my God,
Mark,
that's so
you
funny.
Win. Mark, you're
so
number
funny.
One.
And,
love
and,
it.
And guess who hasn't gotten a text From yep. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Mm. Yeah. What does that
Shady.
Tell you?
Shady.
Yep. I like it. Anyway, one of my granddaughters, our youngest, is one, and we're gonna go out there right after the show. We're gonna go out there and party,
That's
which is
exciting.
Gonna be great. So tell you what, why don't
she's
we go
already
over?
One?
She is.
Golly, time flies.
Is that funny? Hey, how about the wind?
Wild.
Before we get to how about the wind?
So yesterday, delightful. I'm in court on Zoom, right? And the wind is just knocking stuff over left and right. And my dogs are going ape word I can't
right,
say.
Right.
So, and I'm like, and I ended up, court was wiggy, so it ended up being fine. But I'm just sitting there and I'm like, I don't know what I'm going to do because, you know, the wind is crazy and the dogs are absolutely not having it. It was like opening and closing like one of the... like our neighbor's gate.
Yeah.
You know?
Right.
Wild.
You know, out here in Santa Clarita, we have different levels of wind.
Okay.
Okay. When it comes to your trash cans, if your trash cans happen to be out and they're empty, these are the different levels of wind in Santa Clarita. You ready?
Yes, I am ready.
Okay.
This is good
First
to learn.
One is, okay. Hey, it's windy. The lid flipped open on my trash can.
Okay.
Okay. Second one, oh my God, did you see the wind, it tipped over my trash can.
Got it.
That's number two.
Okay.
Number three. You know my trash can's in the neighbor's yard? That's number three. Number four, I found my trash can down the street.
Wow.
Down the street.
Is that a real thing?
And number five, it's I've completely lost my trash can.
Has anyone seen my trash can?
Yeah, sure. It's a real thing. It's a real thing because I just read it. So
I like
figured
it.
It's
oh,
a
so it
thing.
Must be real.
Yeah.
No, but it's crazy. I mean, on the west side, we don't get winds like this. You know, obviously I'm familiar because I've worked out here forever. But like when the girls are awake at 3 o'clock in the morning and that wind is like, good grief. And then we look at our pool and we have a lime tree right by our pool. And there's just bobbing limes just everywhere. I'm sorry.
Down there, they can afford to turn off the wind machines.
Exactly. Not
they've
up
got,
here.
They've got a lot of money there. Okay. Tell you what. What's coming up on today's show in the next 60 seconds?
Woo! How much do you have to make to be the top 1% in these 15 states?
Hey, I'm going to talk about my house being in escrow and how, even though I'm a really, really good realtor, stuff can go sideways.
I'm going to briefly talk about the eviction moratorium.
How about the 10 best cities to buy a home in 2023, and they're all in the South?
Not surprised. Hey, negotiate better without saying a word. 35 tips for reading body language.
Ooh la la. Panic sellers are turning to Open Door later in the game.
Your favorite. Mm-hmm. And hey, outdated MLS policy hides thousands of homes for sale. Woo.
Ooh, baby.
I would not
right.
be happy.
All hey. That and maybe more. Well, no, we don't have any more, but
no,
all
probably.
That. Maybe probably still. All that and less on today's show.
I meant to text you. There's a house for sale by owner down the street from us.
Uh-huh.
And I tried to find it, but it's not listed anywhere. That the MLS article made me think of it. I need to be sneaky and take a picture of the address and send it to you.
Yes.
So I'm like, for sale by owner? What the heck do you think?
Yeah, well, no, it's simple. They say, well, you know what? The last realtor, when he sold me the house, he didn't do anything, so I'm sure I can do that. So I'm just going to put a big FSBO. We call them FSBOs, for sale by owner.
FSBO.
And we just put a FSBO sign in there and just run an ad. And here's the problem with FSBOs.
This is a bad idea.
No, it's a good idea for you.
Oh, yes, fine for me. But
when,
you know
being an attorney,
I should just go put my business card on the step.
Yeah, just
like, you're going to need me.
Yeah, and so FSBOs crack me up because they think that they're going to save the money when it comes to listing with a realtor, right?
Right.
So you get a realtor that calls them up and says, hey, guess what? Would you at least pay me? And a lot of times they'll say no until they realize they can't sell it. And then they'll say, well, okay, if you bring me an offer, at least I'm saving my commission
Got
on
it.
My side,
right.
And yet I'll pay you. Then what happens is the buyer comes in and says, look, you're saving all this money. You know, come down in price.
Right.
So now you're in, if you end up signing off, you have no representation and it's kind of a lose-lose.
And all the forms and stuff, like I would not recommend. It's like people ask me all the time, like, well, can I do this conservatorship by myself? I'm like, can you? For sure. Should you? Absolutely
no way.
Not. And also I looked on Zillow and the MLS and it's not listed. So I'm thinking like, and it's got this dinky little for sale by owner sign in the front yard. I'm like, we live on cul-de-sacs. No one's coming down here. Do
Real
you know
estate,
what I mean?
It's a numbers game. And
yeah.
guess what? They have no numbers
that's
of anybody
that's
See it sees it, and unless somebody drives down the street and sees the sign,
yeah. The
that's
only
it.
Reason I saw it is because I walked the dogs by it.
Yep.
So
trust me, pay a commission, put it in the MLS, and have 60 million people see your property.
Yeah, you know, boys and girls, that is Uncle Phil's lesson of the day.
That's exactly right.
Do not list
right.
your house
yes.
by yourself.
Okay. How about let's go over by the numbers.
I think we should.
Yep. SCV. By the numbers.
Yay!
You want to play again?
You should see his face if you're watching on Facebook Live.
But you come so close. You do, I swear.
I could use $100, actually. You've been, oh. Child care's getting up there, man. All right.
I got to tell you something. By the way, if you do win, I just checked my wallet when I picked up the donuts.
It's okay. I know where you live.
I've got $4.
Four American dollars.
I have this many dollars in my wallet. I tell Judy, I have $4.
Right,
can you give me some more money? She goes, yes, that's fine.
That's so nice.
And then she says, well, what'd you spend the rest on? I mean, the last on. And I just have to tell her.
Isn't that funny? I put money in Greg's wallet all the time.
Really?
Yeah, just because.
I should get in that line.
I know.
Yeah.
You should. Well,
he needs to call me next time
he's in. Taylor's buying.
Yep. Okay, you ready? Between 300 and 400. Okay.
So we're still between 300 and 400.
300 and 400 for active listings for Santa Clarita, which, in case you're, keeping a score at home,
okay.
It's Newhall, Stevenson Ranch, Valencia, Canyon Country, Acton, Agua Dulce, and Castaic and Saugus.
Good job.
Oh, yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
Quiz on that later if you're listening.
You ready?
371.
Oh, gosh, that's close. How about you? Precious, you want to guess?
351.
Oh, she was closer. It's 345.
I was not close at
all. No, I said she was closer.
I know, but you said I was close.
Oh, yeah. Well,
That's not close.
I want to make you feel good about
yourself.
That's
so nice. Yeah.
I want you to leave here going, I came so close in that game today.
Puffery.
Okay. Yeah. That's funny.
Yeah.
How about active under contract and pending?
Between 1 and 2?
Yeah, between 1 and 2.
Do. 147.
Everybody's going between 1 and 2. What's that? That's 1.5.
Taylor, come on.
Yeah, geez. How can you miss that on that? How many?
147.
What do you say?
120.
Did I?
120.
Did I say between 1 and 2?
Yeah.
It's between 2 and 3. Oh.
Sorry. What the heck?
Sorry. Well, you can guess again. You get a new choice because you were wrong the last time.
2.5 is what you're saying.
Yeah,
between 2 and 3.
Yeah, between 2 and 3.
Okay. All right. 247.
Okay. What two?
220.
Oh, very close. 217. I got to tell you something.
Man, she's getting
dangerously close. That's really, really close. Yep. Okay, how about closing last 30 days in Santa Clarita Valley? How many closed? How many actual listings closed in the last 30 days? It's between 1 and 2.
Are you
sure? Promise. Yeah, okay. I promise.
I don't know. 153.
115.
132.
Okay.
Yeah, you were
132 in the last 30 days, so the numbers are pretty much around the same. They have been for the last couple of
weeks. Yeah, actually sales are down, but I think it has a lot to do with the fact that, I don't know, that there's no listings. We're still coming off of the holidays, because anything that sold during December would close in January or the beginning of February, so that's probably what it is.
You know there's not a ton of new listings, because I'm not texting you listings that I like every day. I think I've only sent you one in the last 6 weeks.
Yes.
Yeah, that's a nice house. It's up by you.
I'm
that Stevenson Ranch listing that I really like. Yeah.
Yep. You want to go see it?
She's just beautiful. No.
We can.
Okay. That was easy.
Can
we bring Barkley?
Wow. Am I? No.
I know. No, because the problem is I'll like it and then I'll want it and then,
Okay. So you give me, I don't know what to start with.
Okay.
You want to do the top earners. You want to do top earners? My house. You want to hear my house?
Yeah, let's talk about the house.
Okay. All right. So we remember what happened. The people that bought my house bought it over on FaceTime, right? They live in China. And so she bought it. Everything's fine. However, and there's these little signs. I checked the realtor. He's got, 400, salespeople.
Yeah, you said he checked out.
Yeah. And so, but here are the little red flags that scare me. Yeah. You're going to go, uh-huh. First thing is when you actually give an offer in, you're supposed to give it with actual pre-qual letter and proof of funds.
Correct.
Right? That's easy, right?
We had to do that.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So now I'm thinking, okay, well, obviously, if he's taking care of them, they're, well vetted and it should be okay.
Right, they've got it.
So he gives me a pre-qual letter and he goes, by the way, when I say, okay, I'm going to accept this, but I want to check out the bank. Mm-hmm. He says, by the way, they're going to switch over to East West Bank, which is a good bank and I've heard of East West Bank
of course.
I haven't heard the other one. So I'm like, okay, that makes sense. So he goes, I'll get you that pre-qual letter. Not a problem. Give me a day. And I said, fine. And oh, by the way, proof of funds is coming tonight. And I'm like, okay. So of course,
that's a big piece of the puzzle.
7 days later, I get a text from him, and I've asked him a bunch of times for proof of funds, and I've also asked him for the pre-qual letter. He gives me the lady's name that's doing the loan.
Okay.
No, this is 7 days later. It wasn't 2 days. Right. It was 7 days later. It's not a pre-qual letter, just a phone number. So I call her up and I say, hey, what's going on with this situation? Now, the daughter is buying it with the mother. Mother's not on title. Daughter's buying it with the mother. The mother's basically paying for it.
That's nice.
So they have to get the money from there. Now, they put in a $40,000 deposit. Everything's fine with that, right? But they've got to
get... Okay, well, that's good.
Yeah. Oh, that's excellent.
That makes me feel a little bit better. Okay.
So they've got to get the money that they're putting down. They've got to get that into America, and it has to be seasoned before...
With salt and pepper?
Yes, exactly right. Seasoned just means, obviously, that it needs to sit here to make sure that they know where it came from.
Right.
Now I'm going, okay.
So that's what the loan woman told you.
Yes. Okay. And she says, now remember, they're supposed to have loan approval within the next, complete loan approval, okay, within the next 8-9 days.
Okay.
I'm talking to the lender. She goes, they just called me last night, 7 days in. It was supposed to be 3 days, 7 days in. They just called me last night to set this up. I have to get the money here before I can do anything when it comes to even... putting the loan package together.
Absolutely.
That's going to take 2 weeks.
Oh.
So after 2 weeks, then hopefully within 2 weeks, she's going to have the loan package. Then she's going to submit the loan package. And we're supposed to close it in 45 days.
Oh, no.
And I'm going, this is never going to happen. And so I told her, I said, if in a perfect world, everything goes perfectly, how much time? Mm-hmm. She goes, 45 days. And I said, which means, tells me we're going to close late. Then she throws in, we first have to have the daughter give the mother the money. And I went, the daughter is buying the house. I said, what does the daughter do for a living? She goes, she doesn't work. And I go, the daughter's buying the house. She doesn't work. She needs to transfer cash to the mother. The mother needs to send the money to America. It has to be seasoned. And I'm like going, whoa, wait a minute. Whoa,
my kids are going to be in high school.
I asked, I said,
oh, that's frustrating.
The daughter's buying the house. I said,
so why?
I don't understand. If she doesn't have, she goes, no, the way it works here is if you have enough down payment, which I think was like 45%, you just have to have money what's the word? You have to have money in the account to just make the payments. So many months worth of payments. That's all you have to have. You don't even have to have a job.
Okay.
If you put 40% in, they're putting like $500,000 down.
Okay. Nice.
And they have impounds. That's what it is. You just have to have impounds.
Okay.
But you don't have to have a job.
She has a money tree, apparently.
No. That's what they say. They say you don't...
Okay. All right.
And so I'm going, okay, this is bizarre. Then she says, by the way, in a perfect world, and I go, yeah. And she goes, that $40,000 deposit would be given back to the daughter... And the mother would put in the $40,000 deposit. And I went, this is just getting really weird. So I texted the salesperson and I said, I'm not comfortable with this anymore.
Their agent.
And I can actually, I can, you know.
Well, didn't you have those other people that wanted to buy the house?
They're still there. They keep bugging me going, what's going on? And I'm going, well, you have to understand. I'm getting to the point where I want to cancel this thing. I actually told them. I told the guy at 5 o'clock this morning, we're texting each other back, and he goes,
you text someone else in the morning?
Yeah, no, I apologize. Oh, well, he texted me first, so, you know, I wasn't cheating.
Fair.
Okay. So, anyway, but going back
him?
And forth.
You're like, this is foolishness.
Says, yeah, because I texted him the night before and said, I'm not comfortable with this anymore.
Okay? Fair, yeah, that's weak.
And I'm thinking that it's time for us to bomb this deal. He goes, no. Everything I do closes. And I said,
okay,
well, here's
when,
the
though?
Problem. When I actually went over and went over all of the things that are problem with the loan, he comes back with, for the last 31 years.
I love it.
Yeah.
That's delightful. And that's exactly what you did.
That's, yeah, and it happens every time. This other one that I've got going right now, they wanted to make sure that they didn't have any toxic mold in the place, so we had to go out there and do a mold test
Makes
2 days
sense.
Ago. Yeah. And so, but that worked out.
Okay. Thank goodness.
Yeah. Well, hopefully, it hasn't closed yet.
Toxic mold. My goodness. No, thank you.
Yeah. Okay.
Anyway, so we should take a break, and then we've got some fun stuff to
talk
about.
We'll sell, what, some furniture this time?
That sounds good.
Yeah,
I could use a couch. Stay tuned.
If you're thinking of selling your home, have Phil Nordella come out and give you a free, no-obligation property valuation. Just call 661-312-3561. It's that simple.
Castle Inspection is the top choice for home inspection in Santa Clarita. With over 20 years' experience, make Castle Inspection your choice when buying your new condominium or home. From mobile homes to mansions, the outhouse to the penthouse, your best bet is a net from Castle Inspection. An inspection is a fair and objective evaluation of the home's physical and mechanical systems. Expert knowledge, thorough research, and clear communication are what sets a net at Castle above the rest. Schedule your appointment online now at castleinspection.com.
My name is Frank. I'm the proud owner and operator of Braveheart Termite and Pest Control. I've been doing this for over 25 years. Call me for your termite needs and concerns. If you're in real estate and need a quality home inspection, call me today. You'll have those reports same day or within 24 hours. I will help you solve your issue with what needs to be done and nothing extra. Call me so you can have freedom from termites. 661-373-2617. That's 373-2617.
Are you confused with all the craziness that's going on with the real estate market these days? Well, if you are, you're not alone. I'm Phil Nardella, and I have the knowledge and experience to help guide you through all the confusion. I'll answer your questions and help advise you so that you can accomplish your real estate goals. You can call me directly at 661-312-3561 or get online at philnardella.com. And don't forget, you can always listen to my radio show called Real Estate It's That Simple here on KHTS every Friday morning at 10 a.m. Phil Nardella, eXp Realty, it's that simple.
Your hometown station.
KHTS is the only station I listen to.
98.1 FM and AM 1220.
Hey, okay, welcome back to Real Estate and Other Stuff. Obviously, we always have other stuff on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live. I'm again your friend, hopefully. It's me, Phil Nardella, Taylor Williams, Moniz. We got Precious here on the board, and it's five more shows. That's it.
I know.
After this, it's four.
I know, that's sad.
Yeah, it is sad.
I know. I don't want to talk about it.
Okay.
Yeah.
We got to talk about something, though. You ready for this?
Yeah.
And this is kind of interesting.
A lot to talk about.
You know,
about.
When it comes to real estate and other stuff, this is actually written and it was put into Inman for real estate agents.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But this could be for anybody.
I think it could. Yeah.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. It says, negotiate better without saying a word. That's impossible for realtors because realtors just talk up a storm.
Mm-hmm.
35 tips for reading body language. Find out how to be more conscious of your own body language, so your own body language, how to read others, and how to put your online poker face on.
Okay. Do you have a good poker face?
I do.
Yeah, so do I.
I'll bet you do.
Mm-hmm.
Yours
I have
is scary.
Yeah, it can be. It can be if it needs to be.
Yeah, sometimes I kind of bristle here. I'm like, okay.
But no one wants that face.
Did I say something wrong?
Yeah, no one wants
I
that face.
I apologize. Mm-hmm. It says, okay, so our body language can give us away when we meet clients, walking into an office to a colleague of a colleague or a meeting with an investor. It can convey confidence or betray anxiety.
It can inspire trust
or awaken suspicion. Whoa, who wrote this? Huh? Shakespeare?
My goodness.
Seven body language tips for real estate agents. Okay, first one. Prepare your body language. This one kind of was funny. Prepare your body language before you walk into a room.
So I'm going to liken this to court, right? Because that's sort of my...
Sure.
So, but I do that.
Yeah,
like sometimes I give myself like a pep talk, especially if it's like a gnarly hearing, and then I just kind of do like a full body like
Makes sense.
Then walk in.
Makes sense. Yep.
Just get your mind right.
Every so often somebody I won't do it, you know, behind closed doors, but every so often somebody will actually go, "Oh my God, it's Phil Nardella, and you know, he's got this really accomplished guy," and I'll do this.
He's standing up with his hands on his hips.
That makes for great radio.
Yeah, absolutely.
So anyway, I agree.
Be cognizant of, you know, kind of just get your body, you know, right. Your aura good.
You don't have to adopt your power pose at the negotiating table, however.
And I would hope you don't, because that would be
because
awkward.
Then they would think, this person's scary.
He's special.
Yep. Okay, number two, take tips from actors and check your facial expressions in the mirror.
This is a huge one.
Yeah.
I struggle with this because I am very, like, I have to remind myself, especially in court, like when someone else is talking, especially if, you know, that somebody, it's a witness that's lying or something like that. I want to be like, but you can't, you know.
That is yeah. That's hard.
It is hard.
Because I've been in courts where I've been watching stuff, like with my brother when he was suing whatever.
All that stuff, yeah.
And Anthem Blue Cross. And somebody would say something and you knew it was just, or if I watched Dateline NBC or something.
Yeah.
And I'll go, seriously?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God.
But this, I mean, you know, when you're negotiating or whatnot, or even if you're talking to a client and they're telling you, you know, silly stuff like, well, we're not going to, you know, the living room has green shag carpet on the ceiling, but we love it, so we're not going to take it down. That face. You can't make that face, right? See? Was that a good example?
That's like, am I going to gag? That's like gag
reflex.
Just,
you know, you got to listen and try to, because I have my, I am very expressive with my face, so that is something that I'm very cognizant about also.
Most of the things that I usually do is I always try to make sure at the very beginning, no matter how crazy it is, I go, you know what, I understand exactly what you're saying. In other words, I'm
listening.
I'm
I hear you. I feel you. Yeah.
Now let's talk about how stupid that really was. No, I didn't say that. Okay.
But here's another suggestion.
Number three, watch the other agent for discrepancies in nonverbal communication. That's a big one.
Okay, go on.
You know, and that's one of those things to where you'll be talking to an agent. It's not even. It's like over the phone, right? And you're talking to an agent, and you'll run something by them. And if they pause, you can tell that they're thinking, can I sell this to my client, right?
Right, like,
it's just, there's a lot of different things that when it comes to verbal communications, that a lot of really poor agents give away a lot, and it ends up costing them a lot of money. Mm-hmm. In other words, if I'm talking to another agent and I want to get them to come down a lot of money, a lot of times they will give up and not even know it how much they'll come down. And then I'll go, and that's like, well, that's more than I thought. And so I'm going to ask for this amount.
Yeah, good.
It's fine. It's
okay,
fine.
So pay attention.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Okay. Number four, don't let your eyes give you away. Oh.
Interesting. He's batting his eyelashes.
Does that give me away?
No.
Number five, smile and nod to build rapport. Yeah, that's a good one.
That's always a good one. I try to remind myself just to smile every once in a while, you know. That's just, and
a smile is free, right? I used to tell all the agents, I go, you know what? You know what you can actually give everybody, not just your clients, is you can give them a really good positive mental attitude.
100%.
And yet agents, when they aren't making any money, it's hard for them to pull that positive mental attitude when they're going broke.
I can understand that. Absolutely. Yep. That's hard.
Yep.
But yes.
Okay. Number six, control your inner monologue and keep it from showing on your face. Because I hate to say it, and this is what happens with a lot of people. They don't have a lot of confidence in themselves.
Right.
You know, they're like, this is not going to happen. This is going to fall apart, you know?
Yeah.
It's like I used to always say, if you've got one thing in escrow and it falls out, it's a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
If you have 10 things in escrow and one falls out, it's not that big a deal.
Got it.
So go out there and get 10 things in escrow, right? Done.
Yes. Piece of cake. Well, it were that easy. But this is true.
Some of the stuff that they say, they'll say is, what do I do if I don't get this commission?
Uh-huh.
Will the client say if it doesn't work out?
These sellers are jerks.
Yeah. This guy's a crook. I can't stand him. These sellers are jerks.
I have that sometimes. Like when I have phone calls with opposing counsel, sometimes I'm glad they're not in person or on Zoom because I just sit there and I'm like, I don't want to call so-and-so. But yes.
I've got a...
it's in the privacy of my own office.
I'm not even... I've got, okay.
That happens. Yeah, it happens as well.
Yeah, there's a movement that I make when I don't believe somebody, and it's always the same.
Interesting.
Make eye contact with the camera on video and Zoom.
So this is a big one, especially for people that aren't, you know, like if you're using your iPhone, like don't look at yourself, look at the camera. You know what I mean? Like,
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Right, because sometimes, especially like my iPad, the camera is kind of weird, so you have to look at the camera and not look at yourself.
Yep.
That's important.
Yeah, it is weird if you see somebody talking and they're looking away from you and you're like, okay.
Excuse me, sir. What you doing?
Mm-hmm. Now, how about this? Reading other people's body language, here's what to look for.
Ooh.
Okay, it's kind of fun. Face. What are their telltale signs to look for in terms of a person's face? Looking away or decreased eye contact, that's one. Increased eye contact signals honesty and interest. Red face or throbbing neck or forehead is a definite red light. You think if the guy's foaming at the mouth, I think too, that's probably a red flag that he's very, very unhappy with you.
Oh,
a throbbing
goodness.
Vein almost always means the person's blood pressure is shot up dramatically.
That cracks me up.
Have you ever talked to somebody and their veins start to throb?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Chin up is usually in case defiance. Chin down may indicate dejection, depression, or sadness. And it may merely mean the client is looking at the paperwork. Or it may merely mean the client's looking at the paperwork. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You don't want to say that they're depressed if they're reading something on the table. A raised eyebrow indicates a person's disbelief in what you're saying.
Mm-hmm. I can't raise my eyebrows.
Mm-hmm.
Nope.
Well, you can.
Mm-mm.
No?
Botox.
I was going to say that, and I thought I shouldn't say that.
Oh, you can say that. It's totally fine. I have a wrinkly forehead, so now we got to nip that in the bud.
No, you don't.
Because.
Arms. When it comes to evaluating arm movement, the critical factors are degree and the intensity of the moment. Open arms.
The movement.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I got you.
Yeah. Open arms generally indicate that the person is open to what
this
you are saying.
This makes me laugh. So, like, you're talking to me, and I'm going to look at you and be like, that sounds so great, Phil. If you see me on Facebook Live, my arms are stretched wide. Thank you. Let me receive everything you're telling me. Like, that's funny.
What was it in that movie?
That's a lot to go on.
Titanic?
Oh, yeah.
Remember?
Oh, yeah. Floating.
Thing?
Exactly. Crossed arms.
Crossed arms. Well, that makes sense. Because if you're going to cross your arms like this, it's like, come on, give me a break. You know, that's usually what that means.
Yeah.
The cold shoulder. Oh, seriously, that really is a thing? Cold shoulder. One shoulder pointed at each angle to you is
like
a yellow warning sign. Oh.
Yep.
Well, that looks like you're trying to be sexy, though.
Oh,
yeah.
Thanks. I was not. So there you go.
One arm hanging over the back of the chair indicates that you do not have the client's full acceptance or attention.
Or they're just a casual person.
Well, also, them falling asleep probably says that you don't really have their attention. Okay, hands. What about hands? People's hands provide signals in the following ways. I know one hand signal that tells you a lot.
Me too.
Open and relaxed hands, especially with the palms pointing up, are a green full speed ahead.
There, look.
So, oh, look at you.
I know.
Your
That's
palms
how I was
are,
sitting.
Yeah.
Yep.
Open palms held out like a stop signal means exactly that, stop. Walk around.
I feel like this is something that like my son should be learning about, right? Not us.
Yeah.
Right?
Maybe not until the next grade, like the third grade. Yeah,
he's
yeah. You're
third grade,
right.
He's one and a half.
Yeah, I know, but he's going to be in the third grade before you know it.
He probably will be.
Okay. You know what? Yeah, you're absolutely right. This is kind of interesting, but it's fun.
Yep. So just, you know, pay attention. Consider your audience.
We didn't get to all 35, but we want to, you know, keep people from tuning
I do that
out.
Sometimes with judges when you're speaking and the judge, you know, zones out or opens a, you know, a book and like the civil code and pretends to read it.
Oh,
you're like,
yeah.
Okay, it's time. We've lost his or her attention, right? It's time to pivot. So that's, something good to be aware of.
That one court case of my brother with whatever, the insurance company.
The insurance company.
The funny thing is the attorney kept talking and the judge would say, slow down. She can't pick it up.
The court reporter.
Yeah, she goes, slow down.
I think we've talked about this. Every time I'm in court, on the top of my yellow pad, I write slow down because I speak very quickly when I get excited.
Yep.
And I have to remind
that
myself.
That would have to be a big thing.
Mm-hmm, it is.
It's like sometimes when I listen to this show on the website, I'm like, holy cow, I talk really fast.
I know, right? Yeah.
Do I sound like a turkey?
No. That was just me talking fast. I don't know.
Sounded like a turkey.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So how about this? How much do you have to make to be considered in the top 1% or the top 5% in this 15 states?
Okay.
It's interesting. Number one, to be in the top 1% in Connecticut, which I guess makes sense. I mean, Connecticut is kind of a rich place.
Okay.
You have to make $955,000. If you want to be in the top five, it's only $336,000. That's quite a gap.
It is.
Massachusetts, you have to make $896,000.
To be in the top 1%.
To baby food all over your face.
Good Lord.
Well, you know what? Hey, Wyoming, though, that's the lowest one when it comes to being in the top 5%. You only have to make $233,000 if you want to be in the top 5%.
Well, heck, I'm moving to Wyoming.
Absolutely.
Wyoming's beautiful.
Let's go. So that way we can all say, guess what? We still don't live. And we still don't make 5% in the top
5%. We're rich.
Yep. Okay. So are we ready to go for another commercial?
Yeah, let's do it, because we've got some good stuff coming up.
Perfect.
We'll talk about where we're going to move.
Oh, yeah.
On that
you've got
list of 15.
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
So give us a minute. We'll be right back.
Perfect.
Stay with us.
If you're thinking of selling your home, have Phil Nordella come out and give you a free, no-obligation property valuation. Just call 661-312-3561. It's that simple.
Castle Inspection is the top choice for home inspection in Santa Clarita. With over 20 years' experience, make Castle Inspection your choice when buying your new condominium or home. From mobile homes to mansions, the outhouse to the penthouse, your best bet is a net from Castle Inspection. An inspection is a fair and objective evaluation of the home's physical and mechanical systems. Expert knowledge, thorough research, and clear communication are what sets a net at Castle above the rest. Schedule your appointment online now at castleinspection.com.
Marla Ferris at Augusta Financial is the consummate mortgage professional, committed to helping you turn your dream of homeownership into reality. With more than 22 years in the finance mortgage industry, Marla brings extensive experience and top knowledge to help make your loan experience hassle-free. Given her honesty, integrity, and attention to detail, she is the loan officer you can trust. Marla knows what it takes to get you the best loan, the best rate, and the best service in the industry. You'll find Marla Ferris at MarlaFerris.com.
Are you confused with all the craziness that's going on with the real estate market these days? Well, if you are, you're not alone. I'm Phil Nardella, and I have the knowledge and experience to help guide you through all the confusion. I'll answer your questions and help advise you so that you can accomplish your real estate goals. You can call me directly at 661-312-3561 or get online at philnardella.com. And don't forget, you can always listen to my radio show called Real Estate It's That Simple here on KHTS every Friday morning at 10 a.m. Phil Nardella, eXp Realty, it's that simple.
I love it.
Right on!
Your hometown station.
Okay, hey, welcome back. You know, this hour goes way too quick.
I know.
Welcome back to Real Estate and Other Stuff on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live. Again, it's me, it's Taylor, it's Precious, it's everybody.
Woo-hoo!
It's a party.
It is a party.
Okay, so let's talk. Let's talk about the 10 best cities to buy a home in 2023, and they're all in the South.
So I was born in California, in the Valley, and I moved to Texas when I was 4.
Whoa.
So I'm basically, like, I'm a hybrid of the two, but I consider that I was raised in the South.
Yeah.
So, and I can do the twang, and I still say y'all all the time.
I don't know why. First thing is, I got to ask you, where were you born in the Valley? Do you remember?
West Hills Hospital.
West Hills.
Yeah, West Hills Hospital.
Did they tear that down?
Mm-hmm. No, it's still there.
Is it?
Yeah, they don't deliver babies there anymore. That's why I had to have my kiddos
at Tarzana. Do you remember what little town you lived in the Valley?
What little town?
Yeah. Was it Sherman Oaks or Chatsworth?
Canoga Park.
Canoga Park. My goodness.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
I know.
I was born and raised in North Hollywood, so.
There you go. Yep. And then we moved to big old Texas.
Yep,
I went to
school there.
Was that
Dallas? You went to Dallas?
I went to Dallas, and then I went to undergrad at the University of Texas at Austin.
Look at you.
Hook 'em Horns. Yep.
Yep.
So, yeah.
Awesome.
I'm a nice hybrid.
Well, let's just see.
But so I can fill you in on the South.
I love it.
Yep.
I love it. And, you know, I mean, kind of, I mean, Southern California, that's, you know, South is in the name, right? So, I mean, you really started.
Yeah, exactly.
Even with rising home ownership costs squeezing out buyers, some real estate markets will remain hot in 2023, mostly due to the relative affordability compared with the rest of the U.S. new forecasts find.
Yep.
The top places have something in common, too. They're all located in the South.
Yeah.
Based on a variety of factors, including home affordability, job growth, migration, and I can't see this because it's like cut off, housing supply. The National Association of Realtors analyzed 179 markets to determine which will offer most value to buyers. The data looks back 1 year from October 2022 and reflects expected demand from buyers in 2023. The median price homes in some of these markets isn't cheaper than the national median of $398,500.
That is the national median home price.
That's amazing.
$398,500.
However, these cities scored high on the metrics such as job growth or housing supply.
Number one,
Atlanta, Georgia.
Okay.
Medium price, $371,200.
I like shed a little tear as I was reading this last night. I'm like, that's the median price.
Oh, I know.
Oh my gosh, it's like a down payment in LA.
Yep. Ooh. And here's the interesting thing.
Have you ever been to Georgia?
Yes.
To Atlanta?
Yes.
I like Atlanta.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I went to a never mind.
You went somewhere in Atlanta, y'all.
Yeah. Those little cafe that they have them all over the place there in Georgia.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah. It'll come to me. Okay. With major tech companies such as Apple, Microsoft, and Visa opening Atlanta offices. The weird thing about this is I think more big companies have gone to Austin.
I agree.
And they're not on here. Yep. Okay, number two, Raleigh, North Carolina.
My brother used to live in Raleigh.
Really?
Yep. He lived in Raleigh. It's cute.
Yep, median price home is $460,500, a fast-growing tech hub. A lot of these places are tech hubs. Okay, number three, Dallas-Fort Worth.
That's where I'm from.
See that?
Dallas-Fort Worth.
Yep, medium home price, $390,000. How come mine's ending up costing me $1.2 million? Why is that?
You're moving outside of Austin, which is the very up-and-coming, sexy area.
Dallas,
there's tons of space and area, and it's flat, and there's just lots of land. It's not like here. So
I went to Dallas to because Nick got a job. He did two HEB commercials. Mm. You've heard of HEB?
Absolutely. He used to shop there.
Yeah. He got a commercial here in Hollywood, and he did it, and they liked him so much. The next year, they flew him back, and he did one there, and I had to go with him because he had to have a... So I went with him.
Nice.
It was fun. He was only like 10.
Oh, cool.
It was awesome. It was incredible. Number four, Fayetteville. Springdale, Rogers, Arkansas, Missouri.
Never been.
Yeah, me either. Mm. Medium price home, $328,000. Greenville, Anderson, and Malden, South Carolina. Again. Next one, Charleston, North Charleston, South Carolina.
Okay. Greg and I went to Charleston for our little baby moon. We mixed it in with, we went to a wedding out there. We love it. It's such a fun city.
Really?
Yeah. It's the people are really, really nice, and it's beautiful.
How about Huntsville, Alabama?
I have not been there. I've been to Alabama, but not Huntsville.
Alabama. I hear that's where they invented the toothbrush. You know why I know that? Because if it was anywhere else, they would have called it the teeth brush.
Oh, my gosh.
And I'm kidding.
He'll be here for another 7 minutes, folks.
And if anybody gets upset, I just made that up.
That was actually funny.
Yeah.
I'll take it.
Yeah, toothbrush.
Yeah.
Jacksonville, Florida. That's the next one, $398,000.
I've been there.
Next nine, San Antonio, New Braunfels.
New Braunfels.
New Braunfels. I got to get that right because that's fairly close to San Marcos.
It is. Yeah. So if you go from Austin down to San Antonio, you'll pass through New Braunfels.
Yep.
And there's a huge, Schlitterbahn is what it's called. And it's a water park. And it's awesome.
Oh, I saw pictures of that.
You have to go. It's incredible. But yeah, that's a really fun area as well.
I'll go to Schlitterbahn.
Yep. Ooh, I'll come with you. I'll bring the kids.
Oh, you know what? That's
perfect.
That
would really be fun.
Yeah, that's perfect.
I love it.
There's another place, Pflugerville.
Yeah. Which starts with a P. P-F.
Pflugerville. Doesn't that sound like something out of...
Dr. Seuss?
Dr. Seuss.
It does, yeah.
Knoxville, Tennessee is number 10.
I've been there.
Knoxville, Tennessee. I've never been to Tennessee, but a lot of people are moving to Knoxville.
It says nearly a quarter of renters can still afford to buy a median-priced home with a 10% down payment.
Look at you.
That's good.
You're smart.
I mean, I just read what was on the paper.
I know. It makes you smart. It's good you read it.
I read good.
You read that good.
I did.
Okay, so do you want to just give us a little bit on the moratorium, the eviction moratorium?
LA County has extended it, and again, this is LA County, not LA City, through March 31st. So they've extended it two more months, and the county has said that this is the last time it will be extended. Yeah, right.
Correct.
Everybody hold your watches. But the thing to note, if you're listening, this does not mean if you're a renter, you cannot be evicted. You have to have shown hardship, financial hardship, directly related to COVID. You have to show that. So there's a lot of steps that you have to take in order to, you know, certify that with your landlord. But it's not just, oh, no one can be evicted. You absolutely can. It has to be, hey, I lost my job during COVID. I still don't have a new job, or I'm still looking for a new job, or I just started my new job and I haven't had time to, you know, I've been paying all my other bills. Right. So it has to be, you have to be directly financially impacted due to COVID.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but they started trying to get over that moratorium
last year.
Absolutely. Okay, so I'm correct in assuming that.
It's been extended multiple times. Yep.
Yeah, that's wild. But it's good to know for anybody that's out there, if you're planning on trying to stay and not let them evict you, you're going to have that proof, right?
Right. Well, and landlords, I mean, we represent, you know, a number of landlords. They think that their hands are tied. They're not, right? Your tenant has to have gone through certain protocol in order to be, you know, to have this shelter from eviction. So if anybody has questions on either side, you know, give us a call. We can let you know. But I think, you know, the county's saying COVID is still a real problem and people are still suffering. And landlords are like, well, heck yeah, we are suffering because we've had tenants that haven't paid for years, in
How
fact.
The heck?
So, yeah.
You know, that could throw things off. You know, if you've got a payment to make, you have no choice. You can't go to the bank and say, guess what? They're not paying me, so I can't pay you.
Right. Doesn't work that way. And I mean, a lot
of
landlords,
tough.
Yeah, that we work with did receive COVID assistance because the tenant did what they were supposed to do and applied for it. And the landlord said, yep, this is the rent. And so the landlord did get COVID assistance. But The whole thing is a mess, quite frankly.
Here's another interesting thing with that is you get every so often, you'll get a listing. And you go, you know what? I like it. And you open it up, the pictures, because you see the picture on the outside. And mm-hmm. you open up the pictures, there's no pictures. And you go, okay, that's interesting, because there should be more. And you